Hello there, stranger. Or should I say a friend in the making? Have you ever wondered how Half-Life works on the inside? Have you ever wondered what's actually going on under the hood of the GoldSRC engine? Maybe you're making a mod and you want to have custom weapons or NPCs in it. And if any of that is a yes, well, let's just say today's your lucky day. What you've just witnessed is the power of programming. If you just want to make maps, models, or textures and stuff like that, definitely look elsewhere, because in this series we're going to be writing code. I might make a mapping series eventually, but for now I'm just doing a programming one, alright? Have some patience. But I do have some links in the description so you can like look for that, but yeah, anyway, moving on. Now, this series assumes you're already familiar with programming. And if you don't know how to program, you know, how to write code and all that stuff, well, you're gonna have to pause right here and spend a couple months learning C++ and programming and come back. And I mean it, like, I'm very serious, alright? Because you're gonna need to know, like, you're gonna have to know basic stuff like variables, loops, functions, arrays, pointers, classes, templates, and a bit of object-oriented stuff like inheritance and polymorphism. And I'm really serious, you will need that. Otherwise, you're just gonna run into a wall and complain that something ain't working and you don't understand it, when it's really something basic like, I don't know, missing semicolon or something. So, yeah. If you want to know whether or not you're able to follow this series, just tell me something. Do you understand what this code does? Do you, like, fully understand each line of it? If not, please do yourself a favor and learn a bunch of programming before you attempt this stuff. And this is your final warning. If you don't know programming, you will fail to do basic things. I may do some very tiny hand-holding at the start, but later on, I'll just assume you know the basics. Alright? So yeah, actually, here's a couple of resources you can use along the way. First of all, I got learncpp.com. It has a bunch of chapters, and it's a really, really good rich resource, in my opinion. It's basically a big book, right? It's got a bunch of examples and stuff like that. Now, if you're overwhelmed by that, you can actually use C++.com's fast-paced tutorial series. Instead of having 20-ish or so chapters, it's got like 7 short ones. That's how I learned, actually, like 4 years ago. Now, next up, there's Cherno's video tutorials. Like, if you don't like reading, and you maybe like watching and stuff like that, yeah, definitely go for that. Like, I cannot not recommend his stuff. Like, not only does he cover C++ stuff, right, he also covers OpenGL, engine programming, and Visual Studio tips and tricks, which all of them are going to be terribly useful, like, if you want to do any serious programming on Windows, and if you ever want to do graphics stuff in Half-Life SDK, and maybe understanding, you know, Quake source code and stuff like that. And that's right, you can have custom graphics code in there, but that's like a topic for a video in the far future. Finally, you can grab books, watch GDC talks, read research papers. It's all gonna expand your horizons, like widen your field of view and generally make you aware of all the different ideas out there. And there's a lot to take in, so don't worry if it's super like overwhelming. It's just how it is. But you're gonna know it all. Don't worry about that. Now, that's general C++ stuff and maybe a bit of game programming in general. If you want GoldSRC specific resources, there's generally a few places you might want to check out. So the first one is obviously the whole Half-Life. The mothership, like the last remaining GoldSRC modding site. They have a Discord server where I hang out all the time and you can ask programming questions there, and, well, about Half-Life modding in general. And then there's sourcemodding.com, which has a bunch of links to archives of old tutorials from like old websites like Verk. Verk used to be this really cool website with a bunch of famous modders writing like high-quality articles on it, until it sadly got shut down in the mid-2000s. Thankfully, a bunch of pages have been archived, and sourcemodding.com basically lists a bunch of those. Now, other than that, I also have a Discord server of my own, so if the stuff so far ain't enough, you can come in, hang out, and ask Half-Life modding questions there, right in my face. All links are in the description. Also, there's a bunch of tutorials scattered across ModDB, GameBanana, and probably some other modding sites I'm not aware of. You're like on your own there, but that's as far as I know. Also, please note that this is a GoldSRC series, not Source, nor Source 2 if that's like ever released in the future. The thing is, Source is like significantly different and a lot more complex, although a good chunk of the concepts here will apply to Source just fine. However, all of the like step-by-step stuff I do, it's not gonna apply, it's gonna be different there. Also, Half-Life Source won't work with this, you're gonna need the original Half-Life on Steam. Alright, this also means that like pirated copies and pre-Steam, you know, WAN copies, those are not gonna work with the new SDKs, which is actually what we're gonna be using. Am I understood there, alright? Now, if you're coming from another engine like Unity, Godot, Unreal, Unigine, CryEngine, Flax Engine, Game Maker, I mean, come on, I cannot count them all, but a lot of this stuff is gonna be very different. Some stuff might be similar, but stuff in general is just gonna be quite different. There's no entity components here, there's a full-on client-server model, so if you wanna directly sample any input, you cannot do it in a straightforward way like you would in, say, Unity with the input class. It just works differently here. And I mean, everything works differently here, and you'll see how. If you're coming from source though, yeah, it's gonna be familiar. I mean, what are you even doing here? Just go watch the next video. So with that out of the way, on Windows, you're gonna need Visual Studio, but I guess you can use other tools as well, like, I don't know, JetBrains Writer or Visual Studio Code or whatever. But throughout the series, I'll be using Visual Studio. Don't worry about the version, just go for the latest one. In some videos, I was using 2019, and as of the release date of this video, I'm using 2022. And I guess a few years from now, we're gonna have, I don't know, Visual Studio 2024, maybe 25? It doesn't matter, really. And on Linux, I mean, you're just gonna need a text editor and a compiler, that's all you need. Though, with some SDKs, you may need CMake as well, but don't worry about all that, we'll cover it all in future videos. Once you've got the tools, you're also gonna need an SDK. Do not download Half-Life SDK from Steam. It is incomplete because it doesn't have the C++ code. You'll find the code on GitHub, and there's gonna be quite a few different versions of it. Which ones you gotta use, we'll cover in the next video, part 1, the initial setup. Also, I would highly advise you to learn the basics of mapping too. This series, in some parts, kinda assumes you know basic things, like really basic things about Half-Life modding, like how mod folders are structured, what map entities are, and stuff like that. You can watch Dimbeek's video tutorials for that and read guides in TWHL. You know, download Jack, create a couple of rooms, learn some basic level design stuff, you know, so you just know what you're working with, you know? Because as a programmer, you're either going to be writing entities and systems for mappers, or changing gameplay mechanics one way or another, or doing something entirely else, like some people tend to typically do. Really crazy stuff. Now, the series generally follows a certain format. Usually, there's an intro with our protagonist, Flob, the funny fox blob. Then I introduce you to the topic we're going to be talking about. We do a little bit of analysis, explanations, you know, showing the code, and then an actual example, or maybe a couple of them. Sometimes there's homework, but that's about it. There's a number of chapters, basically, and each chapter covers a certain group of topics. The first couple of chapters are about setting up the SDK and writing really basic map entities, mainly triggers and stuff like that. Chapter 3 is about more advanced map entity stuff, involving animation, effects, and stuff like that. Once that is done, which actually is mostly done as of October 2022, we're gonna start doing weapons, NPCs, and a bunch of other stuff. And by the end of the series, we'll have covered roughly, I don't know, half of the things you can do in the SDK. Because, I mean, you can still do a lot, but for that stuff, like for the really, really advanced stuff you can do in the SDK, there's gonna be a separate series called Half-Life SDK Extras. The name could change, it's still not out yet, but once that's out, you will see a small info label in the corner up here. Now, the reason I started this series was kinda simple. It actually started about 2 years ago, when I was really unhappy with the state of programming tutorials, I mean tutorials in general of Half-Life, and I got inspired by Dimbeek's mapping series, who is a good old friend of mine, so yeah, definitely check him out. My first video in this series was unexpectedly a complete success, and I don't imagine this video is gonna get nearly as much attention as that one did. But the reason I made this video specifically is because, let's just say the audio quality in the first one is pretty poor.
Have you ever wondered, how the heck do entities work on the inside?
And I felt like it didn't answer some of the questions you had. And I mean, it wouldn't be a bad idea to like watch the first video, but this one is gonna be perfectly enough for an introduction. Now, other than this video, I'll also be remaking part 1, the initial setup, and maybe a couple of others. And yeah, as you can see, like, once a video is remade, it's labeled as old, so that's how you can, like, identify them. But yeah, this is one of those downsides of video tutorials, like, when something changes, you just gotta update it. But in this case, you cannot edit a video, you have to upload, like, a new one. But yeah, I live with it. Also, don't forget to read comments in these videos. Because, like, if a bunch of people start posting the same issues, I'm just gonna write a comment addressing all of them and, like, pin it so you can, like, see it easily. But, yeah. Welcome to the world of Half-Life modding. My name is Admer, and until then, happy programming.